step up the pulpit, sounding very slow, one step at a time, one step at a time. We believe as you bring your sacrifice on one side, whatever it is then, that you need, is going, God's going to require sacrifice. But as you come up one side of the mountain with your sacrifice, Jesus comes up the other side of the mountain with a provision. And he only wants to know if you're willing to make that sacrifice. You can go back, call them. You just stare at that saying, I'll tell you what the Lord said. I've been praying about the situation. You know what it is. Lord said to tell you, you're not in the wilderness. So quit complaining and walk in faith. And whatever you want, you speak it out your mouth and you proclaim the goodness of the Lord. And you stop complaining. Because as long as you complain, you'll spend 40 years going around and around in the wilderness. The Lord said, he's telling you, stop complaining and walk in faith in the newness of life and one God. That's what the Lord said. Amen. 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 Thank you, God. We're not going around and around. Not in the wilderness. We operate in faith. Go to the next level, it's going to take a sacrifice. Amen, somebody. Pray, church. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. Come on, Lord. Pray, church. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I'm trying to make sure who's here. There were several in the last couple of days. Come on, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Pray, church. There's some very soft in the back. Help us, Lord. Help us, Holy Ghost. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, God. Very soon. Help us, Holy Ghost. The Lord
into the land of promise.
So what I'm saying, Dr. Casey, is Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Jesus, the Lamb of God that we're about to really understand. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Is the one that takes us into the place. Amen, somebody. Supernaturally. By faith. Y'all get that? He takes us by faith into that place of promise that we cannot get there any other way. That's what we're talking about today, y'all. Are y'all with me? I want you to think about this, because we're going somewhere today. We're going somewhere. The body of Christ is in there. It's in there. Have a breakthrough that you know not of. Y'all hear me? Oh, God, do something. by faith in 2017. You know, I did what I said. So watch this now. I'm talking to them. They know who I'm talking to. I don't talk about what I'm talking about, but they know what I'm talking about. When I got through preaching, y'all hear me. The Lord had fixed it where I couldn't hang around. Y'all hear me, don't you? I wasn't politicking. I wasn't. Now, these right here, they know it. They know it. Lord had fixed it where I couldn't hang around doing politics. God said, I'm going to fix this, and you just let me fix it. One of the home church members, mother had passed away. In her family, y'all remember that?
Yeah.
So it was a big funeral over at Springfield and Newton the same day.
Yeah.
So I had to leave the church and go over there to Springfield and Newton to be with the family. I promised them, Horace and Pam, I said, I'll be there. I said, I'm going to preach that morning, but I'll be there for y'all later on in the evening. Okay, Pastor T. I said, I'll be there. So the Lord had missed it where I couldn't kiss no babies. The Lord had missed it where I couldn't shake no legal hand. The Lord had missed it why I couldn't be doing no politics. The Lord had missed it that I had to get on out of there. Matter of fact, they had to run to the car, say you left your money. I said, I didn't come for no money. God brought you to the earth, don't even look back.
Yes, sir.
What he done
faith, Lord. Speak to us, God, that we know you better. Speak, Lord, for even as Samuel said, thy servant heareth thee and will obey. We ask it all in the precious but master's name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, we pray. Amen. 17th chapter of St. Luke. St. Luke, the 17th chapter. I want to expound on verses 11 through may go to 21, but I'll probably stop about 19. I may go a little farther. I'm going to expound on several verses of 11 through. Before you hear it, sake of time, I'm going to read one verse. Oh my God, tell the church here.
Amen.
And say amen. Let's look at verse 15. And one of them, Luke 17 and 15, and one of them, when he saw that he was healed, you said
amen.
Amen.
And one of them, when he saw that he was healed, and one of them, when he saw that he was healed. We're going to talk from the subject, Miss A. The world says that seeing is believing. But in the kingdom of God, believing is seeing. We come into verse 11 and we find out here in verse 11. Thank you. God bless you. We find out and it says, and it came to pass as he went to Jerusalem that he passed through the midst of Samaria and Galilee. 12. And as he entered into a certain village, there met him 10 men that were leper, which stood afar off. They were keeping the law. And they lifted up their voices. In other words, they were praising. They were praising. It's something about the praise that goes up. Listen, you can't get to the next level in faith without some kind of sacrifice. I don't care. It may be a sacrifice of worship. It may be a sacrifice of praise. Now, when I say worship, there's several different kinds of worship. Your offering is a worship. Come on, somebody. But you cannot get to the next level that without a sacrifice of sorts. Now, this was a sacrifice of praise, Sister Captain. It said, and they lifted up their voices. Now, I want to tell you right now, when you start praising God, something's going to happen. When you start giving God a true sacrifice, something's going to happen. When you start praising him from the depths of your soul, something's going to happen. Lifted up their voices and said, Jesus, said, have mercy on us. Watch this. Mercy gets you out of a place that you deserve. Grace ushers you into a place you don't deserve. But mercy, amen, somebody, gets you out of a place where you do deserve. Now, leprosy at this time was thought of as a disease. And I just got to tell you, it was thought of as a disease, usually as a curse for something you had done wrong. It was thought of it that way. Remember Miriam? Miriam started running that trap. Does God want to speak to Moses? She starts feeling bad about Moses. With that dog woman. Start talking that bad stuff about Moses. And instantly she was a leper. It was thought of as a sin of disobedience, okay? So mercy suited that case. What I'm trying to say is mercy suited the case. Amen, somebody. They weren't saying we didn't do it. They were saying, find me not guilty. That's a big difference, y'all. Some of y'all missed that right now. That's a big difference. Jesus, when Jesus took our case to that Roman cross, he didn't say you didn't do it because you did. If you didn't do it, he never would have had to go to the cross. And listen, if you wasn't talking about somebody, you wouldn't have had to go to the cross. If you wouldn't put somebody down, he wouldn't have had to go to the cross. If you didn't steal, you didn't lie, you didn't cheat, he wouldn't have had to go to the cross. I come out of there and tell you, you did. You did. But he said, by his stripes, you're healed. He said, all of me, you ain't guilty. He didn't say you never did. He said, I am not guilty. The judge has spoken. Amen, somebody. So sometimes you give the mercy suit the case. Ain't God all right? That's the kind of God we got. I need you to watch this. And the Bible says, and when he saw them. Now, can we just be real? Now we know that he's an all-seeing, all-knowing God. But what he saw was the sacrifice of praise. If he's an all-knowing God, and y'all stay with me, if he's an all-knowing, all-seeing God, ain't no way Jesus didn't see them. But what they were trying to do, Mother Taylor, is get his attention. And praise. Anybody need to get God's attention? I hear people all the time, I'm gonna preach to them. I hear people all the time saying, Pastor T, I want you to pray with me. It's like I've been praying, but I don't believe God hear me. You know what I've been gonna tell them? Coming up with a crazy prayer like Pastor T. What you said? You wanna get his attention? Lift up your voice. Amen, somebody. Now watch what it said. They done got his attention. And then we say, then it says, and when he being Jesus saw them. It's almost like he's on the throne. And the Bible says that he's an all-seeing, all-knowing, omniscient, all-seeing, all-knowing, omnipresent God. So he's on the right hand of the Father, petitioning the throne for me, and you. So if he's there doing that, what is it that we need to do? Something about praise that the Bible said that he just kind of gives us a way to to him. He said, speak life to him. It's a dead situation, but speak life to him. It's a bad situation, maybe, but speak life to him. You know what to do?
Believe it is. Oh, hello. Terrell Lynn used to, because I run the average boy. Terrell, can you see yourself doing that again?
Amen.
Softly on top. So there was a little girl there. I thought it was going to be my wife. Says, this is the day. So after church, Pastor Smith delivered a powerful word. So after church, I said, I got something I want to show you. She jumps in my car and drives.
Was that what made
the scripture back up there. He said, your faith have made you whole.
All right.
whether or not 10 that were cleansed, or whether or not 10 that were healed. Now watch what the second prayer does for him. Next verse, he says, well, the nine. He said, Jesus says, whether or not 10 cleansed and healed. Whether or not, next verse, there are not found that return to give glory to God, except for this old son. Somebody who don't even know me. Somebody who's a stranger. Somebody that's not even, I'm not even here to, I wasn't even here to bless you right now. You were supposed to come later. I'm here right now for the Jews. And it's that breed. This person that I didn't really come for, but I couldn't help but notice you. Oh, y'all, am I talking to anybody? I didn't come here for you right now, but because of your praise, because of your worship, because of the glory you gave me, I couldn't help but notice you. You know what I started calling and what I started telling? While others, thou art called. Do not pass me by. Next verse. And he said unto him, arise, stand up. Hold your head up, brother. Stand up, hold your head up, brother. Thy faith has made thee whole. Wholeness. No longer will I complain. Stay with me until I'm done. About all the foolish times that I wasted. You know, man, if I had known this 20 years, I know y'all would say it. Don't say it no more. Because what? God is able to make that stuff up. See, there's a difference in being healed and holy. I'm sure I'm done. The woman with the issue of blood, the Bible says she spent all she had. Now, she had to be wealthy, or women, they wouldn't have made no emphasis that she spent all she had. Y'all see what I'm saying? So she had to be a woman of means. She had to have a lot of chin-chins. Now, he not only healed, he says, I'm going to make you whole. Dear Lee, I'm going to make you just like you were when you used to run all the boys and make them laugh. Good God, ain't that right? See, back in school, if you raised here, you sure wouldn't do it in public. You gonna get dogged out if you run you. Man, you don't let a girl outrun you. So that ain't good. Don't go there. Ain't that right? Listen, not only did he heal, the second phrase made him whole. Nothing missing, nothing lacking. Let me tell you something. Seeing is not believing. Believing is seeing. Give God some praise.